Hey guys, what's going on? Shawn Starker here. Watch Your Attitude, sponsored by LaVille Aviation. And recently at Sun and Fun, I had a chance to catch up with Matt Quinn of Starlight Aerial Productions. You know, they're the ones that did that awesome drone show on Wednesday and Saturday night. If you guys didn't see it, I'm going to put some links down in the comments so that you can check them out. Now, if you're anything like me, I've seen a couple of drone shows on TV and, meh, they weren't all that appealing to me. But seeing one in person, I knew I had to ask them a couple of questions just about how they craft such an amazing performance. And Matt was so gracious enough to spend some time with us, answer not only that, but how they're using their drones to help people. I ask him two of my favorite questions, and we find out what all this has to do with the world's largest portable traveling mermaid tank. Stay tuned. I am just so thrilled to be joined by Matt of the Great Lakes Drone Company. If you guys were here at Sun and Fun on Wednesday night, you saw undoubtedly probably the best drone show I've ever seen. It was just phenomenal. The music, the choreography. And so I'm really interested to find out how you guys do this. I have no frame of reference for drones other than the little one I bought there at the Marshalls. It goes up, takes a couple pictures. But they do a whole bunch of dynamic things with drones, and I want to get Matt to explain some of that to us. So first of all, Matt, thank you for joining us here.
Anytime.
Awesome, man. Tell us a little bit about what you guys have going on, about your drone setup, and kind of what we can expect for the Saturday night show.
So Saturday night show is basically, you know, just like any other air show performance and stuff, it's pretty much going to be the same. The big thing is that when we design shows for an air show or a corporate event or a private show or a festival or whatever and stuff, we always try our best to customize it to the demographics, to the audience, to what we're trying to create. And that's a big thing. That's why we call ourselves a production company, because literally we try and look at it more as a production and as a performance, you know, just like on Broadway or anywhere else, of how can we tie all of these different dynamics in. You know, there's a lot of things that that we can bring to the table that nobody else can bring to the table. I mean, one, just, you know, the shows that we do, how we choreograph the music and the voiceovers and create that story in the sky.
In tribute to all those men and women who love jumping out of perfectly good airplanes, here's a little drone skydiver action.
But not only that, starting this year, we've actually worked with another company and collaborated, and we have an app.
Okay, you guys have your own app.
Yeah, so we'll be launching it this year. For example, here at Sun and Fun. If we came in here to Sun and Fun and we were utilizing the app and everything and stuff, when we start our show, everybody who's here who wanted to be a part of the show downloads this app and everything, and now you become part of the show.
Wow, an interactive drone show, man. That is super awesome.
Yep, so basically we turn all of your phones on, and we light them up in different colors. So based on where you're at in the audience and everything and stuff, it's this big, colorful event that's going on and everything. We can also play music through it. We can play videos through it. We can do all sorts of different stuff, but we make the audience a part of the show.
How incredible. I bet they love that.
Oh, yeah. So the few times that we've done it in testing and everything and stuff, it's been amazing. The cool thing is we can actually, like, vibrate your phone. So, like, when we hit, like, key points in a show or something like that, we can vibrate it and stuff. We can prompt you, okay, get ready to take a picture. If you want a picture, this is your picture that you want to take and everything and stuff. Because it's really, really hard to shoot our show.
Sure.
Because with the movements of the drones in the sky and the lights and everything, your phone's constantly going in and out of focus and everything.
Yeah.
And we always design key points in the show where it holds for like about 5 seconds so that you can get those shots.
Okay.
Of different shapes that we think are important that people want to get photos of. So
I like that. Yeah, I tried to get some video the other night, and nobody but my friends on acid really appreciated it. So it was tough. A lot of blurry going on, kind of threw me back. But, you know, you guys... you have this collection of drones here, but and they look totally different than the ones that I've picked up. What is special about these? Kind of
so when we're looking at the drones and everything and stuff, so these drones are custom built. So we build them all. Okay, so we order the parts and everything and stuff. We build them, we put them together, we 3D print the GPS holders.
Okay.
So this is the GPS compass and everything and stuff. Flight controllers in here. We run two simultaneously communication systems.
Okay.
So we have one here and we have one here. The LED boards on here and the globes and everything are custom made. The LED boards are the brightest on the drone show market. We know that with 99% accuracy, they're the brightest on the market. We have a patent for them. We have them built with a local PCB company for us.
Sure.
And then we have our globes, which our globes are honestly just, you know, arts and crafts projects that we set there and sand out to create the diffuser.
Okay.
But the unique aspect and everything and stuff is because of the way we build them and everything and stuff, you know, you see all these wonderful little zip ties and everything. Over time and experience, even the GPS holder and stuff, so we have to allow for vibration. So that vibration and everything and stuff is what affects the flight controller on how it feels movement, forward, backward, left and right, to make decisions.
Okay.
So by putting the zip ties, we limit some of the vibration, but some of the key points is like if we have a hard landing or if we have a crash or anything and stuff like that, we disperse all the kinetic energy, saving the core of the aircraft. And we're the only ones on the air show market, or in the we're the only drone company that's a part of ICAS, the International Convention of Air Shows.
Okay, yeah.
And we've literally consulted with the FAA and coordinated with the FAA and created all the rules for drones at air shows.
Oh, wow.
So, you know, it's funny, every time we come and do one of these air shows and stuff, anytime that we do the FAA inspections and everything and stuff, it's more of a learning experience for the FAA
working
with us.
Right.
In fact, one of the guys I was working with when we got here and everything and stuff, he comes over and everything, we're talking and stuff, and he's like, no, you tell me what we're all doing and stuff, because I know that you were part of writing all these rules and everything.
That
so,
is very cool. Look at you, man. Got a little legacy going on in there.
Yeah, I mean, we're trying to make it so, I mean, this... manned aviation, contrary to some beliefs, will never disappear.
I agree.
Okay.
Yeah.
You know, some people say that unmanned's going to take it over, and I'm a strong believer that's never going to happen. Because first of all, no one's going to build an autopilot system for these T-34s or these B-17s or anything and stuff that's going to fly them completely unmanned. Because you know, and like these air shows and everything. I mean, you can train these flight controllers to do some really cool stuff, but yeah, there's some stuff that, you know, it has to have that human element.
I agree.
You know?
I agree.
And, but there's a lot of things that we can do in the unmanned world, in the airshow industry, and just in general. And I think it's going to be a huge multiplier in the future. So.
For sure. Yeah, there's room for both, no doubt. I mean,
you know, we're collaborating with a couple other performers on some collab shows.
Okay.
So.
Uh-oh, got some things in the works.
Yep.
Big things. You guys heard that here first. Big things. That's cool. I'd never been to a drone show before. I wasn't really sure what to expect.
No one ever is.
Right. You know, with a drone, you know.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yep.
Quite the opposite. I mean, I didn't even look at my phone. I did try to take some pictures, but I was just kind of, my mouth was going, wow, how did they do this? So I really, really came to appreciate that, you know, that's a heck of an art up there.
Yeah, it's a lot harder than what people think it is. I mean, especially like all the work leading up to it, you know, creating the shape, seeing what looks good, and then, you know, what a lot of people don't realize is all the drones up there in the sky, they're all 9 feet apart on all three axes.
Okay.
And so depending on where you're at in the audience and everything, they look really close or
Definitely. They
look really far away. And then, you know, we opened with that whole, like, you know, Top Gun, Back to the Future sequence type
Sweet.
Thing. And we've learned over time how to create visual illusions. And I'll wait for the T-34s. I've actually flown in one of those.
Have you really?
The T-34 and the T-28s. I've flown in those.
Nice.
Yeah. You can't make that stuff up. I mean, you can watch all the videos you want, but until you actually take a ride in one of those things. So.
Yeah.
But anyway, back into that Top Gun sequence and stuff. What a lot of people don't realize is, you know, we had people down at the end of the runway that said that they felt like it was literally coming down the runway and everything and stuff. And in all reality, it only moves 25 feet forward.
Oh, wow.
So it moves 25 feet forward, and then all the drones expand from like 9 feet apart to 25 feet apart.
Okay.
In that little short time and everything. So it makes it look like it's coming down, because at night we're able to capitalize on some of those visual illusions.
Sure. You don't just do the drone production, you also have other things that, that
yeah,
you do.
So we have other divisions of our company. So Starlight Aerial Productions is our drone light show division. In fact, hopefully by the end of May, our new website for that will be up. It'll be starlightdroneshows.com.
Okay.
It's there. It's just being built in the background and stuff. GreatLakesDroneCompany.com. Obviously, we have all of our social media for Starlight and for Great Lakes Drone. But at Great Lakes Drone, you'll see we have our whole emergency services division. We have 911 contracts with about five counties and multiple departments within those counties. So if you're up in Michigan and you go missing or you run from the cops or something like that, it may be one of our drones that are out there assisting on that project.
That is so cool.
And then we just most recently opened up our agricultural crop spraying division. We got our Part 137 exemption. We're just waiting for our Part 137 certificate to come in, which will come in as soon as probably we get back and do our flight testing. Yeah. Well, so like during COVID, obviously we weren't doing shows, so we took our swarm technology here and put them on the crop spraying drone. So we can have one pilot up to 16 crop spraying drones at a time.
Okay.
And, you know, so we just sit there and tell, okay, here's the field. Mark out the field, mark out the obstacles. I need 1 gallon per acre, 2 gallons per acre, whatever and stuff. Have 16 drones sitting there and stuff. They carry 3 gallons per drone. Sit there and say, go start. They go out there, do their thing. When they need a battery, they need more fluid, they just come back, land. We refill them and stuff. They go back out and do it. We actually own another company. And that's our character aqua performance group. So some of our staff, which you met, you know, they do a side hustle. They're mermaids.
Nice.
So we have North America's largest traveling portable mermaid tank for festivals and stuff like that.
Whoa! I have got to check that out.
And then if you stick around later and stuff, you may see Bumblebee or Iron Man walking around here at Sun and Fun today. So
did you guys hear that? That is awesome. We may catch a glimpse of Bumblebee or Iron Man here at Sun and Fun. Now that's putting the fun in Sun and Fun. And I tell you what, there's no shortage of the sun either, man. I'm getting cooked out here. So I want to wrap this thing up real quick with a couple of fun questions. Are you up for it?
Sure. Go ahead.
So let's say you're flying down here. You got a good bit of flight time. So what do you like to eat up there? I mean, you got to get hungry while you're flying. What's your favorite in-flight snack?
The in-flight snack of choice is probably going to be jerky, man.
Oh, yep. That's
it's always going to be jerky.
High protein, keeps you full.
Always.
Definitely. And it doesn't weigh much. You can slide it in a pocket.
Of course.
And you just brush the dirt right off. Doesn't even need a covering. So,
you know how much jerky can actually fit on a drone?
That is a question for the audience. You know what? Take a guess at that, guys. How much jerky can you fit on a drone? And I'm gonna get the answer here in just a second. Now, if you could fly any aircraft throughout history, what would it be?
That's a tough one. I'm torn between the P-51 and the B-17.
Nice.
I'm sorry, man. I'm an old school type person. One of our friends, Scott, who flies the class of 45.
Okay.
His P-51 and everything and stuff. I keep giving him a hard time. It's like, okay, man, where's my ride?
Seriously. Give the man a ride.
But those guys do like a great performance and everything and stuff. And then, you know, shout outs to obviously, you know, our friends with, you know, Redline Air Shows and, you know, Mark Thornton from Twin Tigers. Everybody knows him and everything and stuff. And we're hoping that we're going to see him back up in the air here sooner or later. So, but a lot of collabs coming, more air shows coming this year. So
awesome.
Watch out. We got some cool things planned.
Watch out. I'm going to stay ready. Y'all going to stay ready? Make sure to follow them online, Great Lakes Drone Company. They're going to have their new website up here shortly for their Starlight Productions. Follow them on social media. Guys, thanks for joining us on the Watch Your Attitude podcast. And Matt, good luck for Saturday night, brother.
All right, man. Sounds good.
Spoiler alert, guys, to the surprise of exactly no one, Matt and his team over at Starlight Aerial Productions absolutely crushed the Saturday night show. I think they improved on an already awesome Wednesday night show. So congratulations to everyone over there. And of course, a big thank you to Matt and his team for sitting down with us at Sun and Fun and giving us so much of their time. I really enjoyed every minute of it. Now, if you guys want to check them out online, you can look down in the comments. I'm going to have their social media, Great Lakes Drone Company and Starlight Aerial Productions. You can see all the awesome things that they're doing. Be sure to drop in and tell them hello if you see them out and about at any of the festivals or air shows. And we are looking forward to the next time we get to see them because I have got to know more about the world's largest portable traveling mermaid tank. You guys stay tuned. We'll do that on future episodes. Until then, guys, keep your head in the clouds and always watch your attitude. We'll see you next time.